we want to write each product in exponential form. In exponential form, we have a base and an exponent. So for 3 times 3, the factor is 3, so the base is 3. And because we have two factors of 3, our exponent is 2. We can say 3 to the second power, or 3 squared. Notice for the second example, we have factors of 2, so the base is 2. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 factors of 2, so our exponent is 5. This is 2 to the fifth power, or just 2 to the fifth. Next, we have a base of negative 4. So we're going to put negative 4 in parentheses. And then we have negative 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 times. So we have negative 4 to the fourth power. Now, in this example, it is important that we have the parentheses. If we left them off, now the base would actually be positive 4, not negative 4. If we expanded this, we would have negative, or the opposite of, 4 times 4 times 4 times 4. So here the base is positive 4, and since our base is negative 4, we do need the negative 4 in parentheses. Exponential form involving variables is done the same way. Our base is x, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 factors of x, so this would be x to the 6th. Next, our base is 7b, so we'll put 7b in parentheses. Then we have 1, 2, 3 factors of 7b, so our exponent is 3. This can be read 7b to the third, or 7b cubed. Now I do want to mention here that, now I do want to mention one more thing on this example. 7b does mean 7 times b. And because multiplication is commutative, we could change the order of this. We could write this as 7 times 7 times 7 times b times b times b. And then in this form, we could write this as 7 to the third b to the third. But since it was given to us in this form, we'll leave it as a base of 7b with an exponent of 3. In the last example, notice how we have 3 factors of a and 2 factors of b. So we'd write this as a to the third, or a cubed, and b to the second power, or b squared.